Our speaker will be Isaac Felix. He's a PhD student here at the university. Isaac, the stage is yours.
Thank you very much, Paulo. Hello, everybody. So I'm going to present the work thermal transport in 2D superlattice of graphene and boron nitride. Okay. So this outline of my presentation. First, I will make a brief introduction where I talk about the crystalline structures of graphene and boron nitride, and the thermophysical properties of graphene and boron nitride. And then I'll talk about what motivated us to carry out this study and the methodology we use to calculate the thermal conductivity of these structures. Finally, I will present our main results and conclusions. So, as you know, the control of the physical properties of nanomaterials has been one of the main responsible for the advancement of nanotechnology. This has motivated studies of new nanomaterials with controlled physical properties by combining two or more different materials. Recently, single-layer structure of graphene in boron nitride were produced via lithography patterns coupled with chemical vapor deposition. This approach enables fabrication of graphene and boron nitride that are continuous and easily transferable to substrates. As you know, the crystalline structures of graphene and boron nitride are quite similar. The difference is that graphene is composed only of carbon atoms distributed in hexagonal vertices of honeycomb lattice, while boron nitride is composed only of carbon atoms. The boron nitride is composed of boron and nitrogen atoms. Concerning the thermal transport, graphene presents the highest thermal conductivity among no material, while boron nitride presents the thermal conductivity on order of magnitude smaller than graphene. In both materials, at room temperature, the phonons are made with carriers. Motivated by possibility to experimental synthesis of graphene and boron nitride, we propose to investigate the thermal transport in periodic and quasi-periodic graphene and boron nitride nanohimbles for different superlattice periods via non-equilibrium molecular dynamic simulations. In our approach, we fixed the width in 5 nanometers, and we used only a quartz domain size of graphene and boron nitride. Furthermore, we use periodic boundary conditions in the x direction and free boundary conditions in the other directions. To impose the width flux in the systems, we used the Miller plot method. This head flux is imposed by exchange kinetic energy of slow move particles in the rotary regions with the fast move particles, fast move particles in the cold regions. In response, we obtain a temperature gradient of the system. Using the temperature gradient and the read flux in the Fourier's law, we get the thermal conductivity of the systems. In the present work, were performed with computational package lamps. We employed the test of empirical potential to reproduce the vibrational properties of graphene in boron nitride. And initially, the simulations were thermalized with a Nozzle-Roth thermostat at room temperature. Therefore, the following results correspond to room temperature conditions. Okay, first I will present the thermal transport in periodic graphene boron nitride. We analyzed the thermal transport in periodic graphene nanohimbles with different supercells But equal domain size of graphene and boron nitride. First, we analyze the dependence on the thermal conductivity with the nanohub length. Here we have the measurements for nanohub with domain size of 0.43 nanometers. We can predict this dependence by this formula, where kappa is the intrinsic thermal conductivity, lambda is the effective phonemeia free path, and L is the sample length. This is a nonlinear fit obtained by this formula. We also observe the same behavior for nanohubs with other superlattice periods and domain size. Okay, we observe three heat transport regimes in this figure. Initially, we have first one have the ballistic regime, where the dependence on the thermal conductivity is linear with nanohub length. Second, we have the diffuse regime, where the thermal conductivity shows a weak dependence on nanohub length. And between these two regions, we have the transition ballistic diffuse regime, where the nanohub length becomes comparable to effective phonemeia free path. So here we have other measurements for nanohubs with other domain size. And we observe that the dependence on the thermal conductivity with nanohub length decreases as the domain size increases up to 1.72 nanometers. And then it increases in order to understand this dependence on the thermal conductivity with domain size, we investigate these results. Here we have typically non-monotonic dependence of the thermal conductivity with the domain size with for nanohubs with different domain size. Another shape filtering non-monotonic of the thermal conductivity with domain size is expected according to the literature. And to illustrate some nanohub length, some domain size of graphene and boron nitride, we have know that this data point corresponds to this rainbow, this data point corresponds to this rainbow, and this data point corresponds to this rainbow. Initially, the increase in domain size in of the thermal conductivity. Initially, an increase in domain size. Okay. Okay. Initially, increase in domain size causes the thermal conductivity decrease until it hits a minimum value of 89 watts per Kelvin, with when the domain size is set 1.72 nanometers, and then it increases. I will divide this figure in two regions, one on the thermal conductivity decrease and another on the increase. Typically, the minimum thermal conductivity is a consequence of the crossover from coherent to incoherent the thermal transport. The coherent regime thermal transport is set. The thermal transport is set coherent when the phonon behaves like a wave, and incoherent, the phonon thermal transport is set. Okay. Okay. On the right of the minimum, we have the coherent thermal transport, and on the left of the minimum, we have the incoherent thermal transport. The coherent thermal transport is said. We have the coherent thermal transport when the phone behaves like a wave, and we have the incoherent thermal transport when the phone behaves like particles. The combination of wave interference effects that coherent phone experience and the diffuse interface is carried in that incoherent phone experience lead to a minimal local thermal activity as a function of domain size. Furthermore, the minimal thermal conductivity is observed when the superlight period is comparable to phone non-coherent length. These results were recently published in scientific reports, and our results are in agreement with previous theoretic predictions and experiments. Therefore, simulation experiments in theory confirm this phenomenology in thermal transport of superlights. Okay. But if what if the superlight is not periodic? Okay, Professor Luis Felipe. Actually, this new project started like this. Typically, the periodic sequence. Typically, the superlight periods in periodic superlights following the periodic sequence, and the quasi-periodic superlights following the quasi-periodic sequence. Recently, we investigated the thermal transport in quasi-periodic sequence with four nanohimbles that following the Fibonacci sequence. The Fibonacci sequence is obtained by inflation rule according to this picture. A goes in AB and B goes in A into A. In this work, we consider each Fibonacci generation as a different supercell when the block A represents the boron nitride and B represents the graphene. And here we have the superlattice periods for different Fibonacci generations. We have the periodic case corresponding to the periodic case. We have the following, the other Fibonacci generations. We observe the thermal conductivity decrease with according to Fibonacci generation increase. And this we also observe that the quasi-periodicity decrease the thermal conductivity mainly where the thermal transport regime is coherent. This is because the translational symmetry decreases as the Fibonacci generation increases. Thus, coherent phones of various wavelengths are scattered with different length scales. Okay, in progress we have working in this work in in this new configuration of quasi-periodic superlattice. We use the two MOS sequence and double pulse sequence. And this is the results. We observe that the heat transport in these cross-parallel superlattices is similar to the heat transport in Fibonacci superlattices. And basically, in conclusion, our work shows that it's possible to control the thermal conductivity of graphene and bornitride superlattices from the domain size. In periodic nanohimbles, the thermal conductivity is non-monotonic as a function of domain size. Its minimum value represents the wave particle cross of the thermal transport. In quasi-periodic nanohimbles, the thermal conductivity decreases as periodic generation increases. It's because the phonons of various wavelengths can be scattered in different length scales. Finally, we believe that the suppression of coherent thermal transport in graphene superlattices enables a control on heat conduction at the nanoscale, which has the potential to improve the design of novel thermoelectric devices. Okay, thank you, and sorry by my English.
Thank you, Isaac, for this nice talk.
Okay.
And we have a lot of time for questions.
So in the last slides, you showed some results on this Fibonacci series and some indication of what you are going to get.